welcome to Good Libations, which is our show about mixology. And as you know, I'm a mixologist, Ethel Andrews. And again, you'll notice I'm wearing a COVID mask because I want to set a good example about being cautious during this pandemic and actually adhering to the safety precautions that we've all been encouraged to use. But for the sake of demonstrating, I'm going to remove the mask for now. And we are on an adventure and a mission to make cocktails based on scotch, because that is a much neglected alcohol when it comes to cocktails. People say, oh, scotch has too much of a smoky note, it's too pronounced, it doesn't work in cocktails, and that is absolutely untrue. And we can go beyond the Rob Roy, which is basically a scotch Manhattan, and we can go beyond the Rusty Nail, and of course, scotch and soda, talk about lack of creativity, and we can actually make interesting, innovative, creative cocktails utilizing scotch. And this particular one is quite interesting. It's the Lady Ballentre. And for those of you who ever read the Robert Louis Stevenson book, Master of Ballentre, about the two brothers who vied for control over their family, you might say. It was called the Master of Ballentre. This is Lady Ballentre. And also there was a movie with Errol Flynn in it years ago, decades ago, that was based on that very novel. And of course they call him Robert Louis Stevenson in Scotland, but we would say Robert Louis Stevenson here in the United States. But at any rate, being that I'm old, and most of my viewers here wouldn't have a clue what this is all about, that's where the name Lady Ballentre came from. So this particular drink is quite interesting because it utilizes ginger and scotch, among other things. And we're actually going to grate some ginger here so that we can utilize it in this cocktail. And we want a suitable amount too. We want it to be subtle, but not so subtle that you don't even notice it's there. And at the same time too, we don't want to use so much of it that it overpowers the scotch and the other ingredients. So there, I think we have a suitable amount of ginger that we are going to actually transfer into the cocktail shaker. And boy, that fragrance is wonderful. And you really are better off if you buy fresh ginger root so that you can, you know, grate it and put it into this cocktail. And don't just think, oh, I could use ginger powder or ginger root that's been candied. Don't even go there. Okay, and now we're going to add the scotch, the main ingredient to this delightful drink here. I'm going to add a decent amount of it. And again, we're making drinks for sampling, not for imbibing a whole cocktail. So the amounts that I'm going to add might seem a little bit stingy, but it's appropriate for what we're doing at this time. And this drink actually incorporates maple syrup, if you could believe that. So I'm going to add a bit of maple syrup here. And maple syrup actually goes very well with scotch because it too has a pronounced flavor that's unique and is one of its own. So that is the perfect thing to add. And now we're going to add some fresh lemon to counter any excess of the maple syrup that's in the drink. And hand squeeze the fruit, as I endlessly lecture. Don't, you know, use a juicer because you're going to miss the infusion of the oil from the rind. And then I always like to drop the rest of it into there, the spent shell, so that again you get more of an infusion into the actual cocktail. And in addition to this, and this seems incongruous and strange, we're going to add a little bit of peach infusion, and not peach liqueur because that's way too sweet, but peach infusion. And most people think, oh, that's more akin to something that you should have with bourbon. And while that may be true, this actually kicks up the drink into a different dimension. And it plays off the ginger very, very well. So here we have scotch, ginger root, maple syrup, a bit of lemon, fresh lemon, and peach infusion. And I'm gonna add the ice, and then we're gonna shake this up. And then we'll disperse it into our nice little glass that is suitable for scotch drinks. And again, this is called the Lady Ballentre, which gives it a nice little theme for scotch whiskey. And the actual town of Ballentre is in Ayrshire, pretty close to the coast. So that was the locale of the movie and also the setting of the novel. And you know, it's very pretty in that part of Scotland too. In fact, in most of Scotland, it's quite pretty. So we're gonna try out the Lady Ballentre. And we wanna use a good amount of scotch, a hint of the peach infusion, not liqueur, and maple syrup and lemon. Those are the necessary ingredients in this drink, and now we're going to try it out and see if it turned out as it should have. And I want to mention again that we're sampling these drinks, not making whole drinks. Normally, this would be filled about up to this mark here, but that's not necessary because we're not serving these for a party. So I'm going to go ahead and try it out and see how it turned out. Very nice. And I must say, every ingredient stands out in this drink. You know, the scotch, of course, is the main ingredient and it shines through. But you can taste the ginger. You can taste the peach infusion, and you can taste the lemon. And one thing that I stupidly omitted was to muddle, what can I say, the ginger. We all make mistakes. Muddle up that ginger, and you're going to have to use more power than you normally would. In fact, more of a pulverizing, because the ginger is harder than using other things like rosemary and mint. So anyway, this will show you if you miss certain things and goof up, it's not the end of the world. You can always fix it. So now that I fixed it, I'm going to add the rest of it here. That shouldn't make a tremendous difference, but it does make a difference. So we want to make it right and make it the right way. Oh yeah, that made all the difference. And I want to mention too that many people think that mixology is some sort of an esoteric art that only certain people can do. Absolutely not. Anyone can master mixology. If you enjoy it, and that's the main thing, if you enjoy it, then you're going to have a natural aptitude for it. So experiment, try, put your own flourishes and your own touches on drinks, create your own drink recipes, and just remember some basic things like the use of lemon goes very well with scotch, but you would not use lime with scotch, never, ever. So things like that are good to know, and certain ingredients are not going to marry with different base liquors. And it's always good to keep that in mind, but don't think that there's rigidity to it either. You can experiment by your own taste buds, what works and what does not work. But the Lady Ballentre is very nice. I think all would enjoy that. And thank you again for tuning into an episode of Good Libations. I'm Ethel Andrews, I'm a mixologist, which is kind of a snobby, effete term for bartender. And the key is to use fresh ingredients, decent but not necessarily top shelf liquors, and to make sure that you're innovative and creative. Thank you for tuning in, and let's keep our community safe and well spoken of by being very careful what we do when it involves driving and drinking. Thank you again. Goodbye.